Hey, hi everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Like, it has been a long time since I made any video on suspension design or car design. Like, I got this job in which I have to move to a new city, and I got held up with work and other life-related and job-related stuff. So yeah, like, I was not able to get time. So now I thought, like, I can give it a try on Sundays or like on weekends. And I came up with some ideas. Like, I was going through some of my old files, so on which I can rework and also make some new contents. So yeah, like, today's video is about designing, A-arm designing. Okay, like, I will be covering designing and manufacturing aspects of designing A-arm. Okay, so this design one can easily make using normal pipes. Okay, like, one should use steel grade pipes which are available in market with good quality. Okay, so like, we have AISI 1018, AISI 4130, AISI 1020. So these grades are easily available in market, like 300 to 400 rupees per meter. Yeah, so one can get them and fabricate in a machine lab, you know, like, so it normally involves process like cutting, grooving and welding. Okay, but some precision is required, so they can make some 2D drawing, and they can place and place some fixtures, and like that, they can, these AMs are easily manufacturable. Okay, one can go for CNC bending also, CNC bending and laser cut grooves, and then they can use fixtures to weld to get a proper precise design of AMs. Okay, so now let's come to the video. Here we are in the Solidworks software. I already have the suspension geometry, like, in which I have some base parameters, like track width and ground clearance and wheelbase. Okay, I have a front suspension box. So here we have this double wishbone suspension. Okay, in which there is a upper A-arm and a lower control, lower A-arm, like A-arms, or you can say control arm. They are literally same thing. Okay, so yeah, if you see this, we have mounted one shock absorber here. So one mount is present on the body, which is the upper mount, and one mount is present on the lower lower control arm. So like that, we have designed, like, I have designed this. Okay, and this is, there is the knuckle geometry. So it is nothing, just a wireframe made up of 3D sketches and some lines. Okay, so let's I'll be using how we will be designing. So it is simple, like, one should have a suspension layout, okay, like this. Okay, and with the help of 3D sketches, 3D lines, and with the weldment toolbar, weldment features, we will be using the design, we will be making the design of AM. So in weldment feature, if you go, like, depending on the country or the standard which your country usually follows, you can choose ISO or ANISI. Like, American system will be using inch, and ISO standard is for Indian and other countries, which uses millimeters as the unit. So in this toolbar, in this feature, like, you can select any type of cross section. You can select any cross section. I already made a video previously how to make a custom cross section of profile. So I will give the link of that in description, and you can also follow this I button. So here we are going to use 21.3 into 2.3. okay, this configuration. like the outer diameter as 21.3 and the thickness will be 2.3 mm we will be using. So yeah, we will come on to this thing later, but first let's create the 3D sketches. So I'm going to 3D sketch and we'll select a line option. And here I'm creating a line. Okay, so line I am going to make along the Z-axis. So you can see like it will be a straight line along the Z-axis. Okay, so I will try to connect the line to this point. So this is a rear mount, rear upper mount of the upper arm. Okay. So there will be a C-clamp, C-type, C-shaped clamp, which we can weld on this vertical structure. And yeah, we can place our mounting of the A-arm here. So I'm not going to make the line at the very middle of the point. I don't want to make it symmetrical. Like I will create some offset. Like why I am doing, I will be explaining it later because of some groove setting. Okay, so let's give some length to this. Okay, so the length, because we will be using pipe and the diameter of the pipe is 21.3. So I will suggest you to keep the length of this at least twice. Yeah, more than twice will be appreciable. So 50 we are keeping. And the offset I will try to maintain from the middle. We will try to maintain some offset also. Okay, so give that as well to define the line. Okay, so let's give 15 millimeters. Okay, so this is done. This is set. Now we will move to the front mounting of the upper arm. So here also there will be a C-clamp. And in that C-clamp there will be a pipe like pipe shape. Okay, so for that we are making line. So once again the same distance we will same length we will keep, let's say 50. Okay, and we'll try to maintain some offset also. Okay, because if you will keep at the center, then the groove will be short, because here the groove which will come from the design of AM, it will be angled. So the length of groove will be very much lengthy. So it will not sit correctly on the line. So here what we are doing, we will be making one more line. Okay. So here, this section of AM, usually we will be making with bearing seat. So there is a, you can use bearing seat or you can make some pipes also. So I'm using pipe here. Okay, but here the bearing, the ball bearing we will be using. Okay, so the ball bearing should sit inside the pipe, so you need to select the diameter of the ball bearing accordingly. You can make a custom bearing seat using a solid material, and then you can do operation on lathe. Okay, so yeah, I'm using a line again, and that line should be collinear with this suspension geometry line. So this is the knuckle axis, like what we call the steering axis, or you can say the caster line. Okay, so if you view from side view, it's a caster axis. Okay, so first we will make it like let's say if you are having trouble in making the line, make it in a front view and try to make it coincide some in some way. Like yeah, I have selected the two lines now and made it collinear. Now it is passing through that exact line. So now we will control the length. Okay, so give some length again. Like you need to give more than the diameter of the pipe, the AM pipe which you have selected. So in this case we will be giving 30 mm. Okay, so now our connectors, so these like are connectors. Okay, I mean they will connect at the hard points. So the hard points are which will not move. Okay, hard points of suspension which will be stay fixed Okay. So like this, we have connected the line, okay, one line coming from the rear mounting and one line coming from the front mounting, and they are merging at the upper ball joint. So there, which I have just made that line, they are merging at that. So this is how the layout of the A-arm will look like, okay? So yeah, you can have a proper look at this, okay? If you feel any clash will happen, so you can adjust the lines accordingly, okay? Now exit the sketch and just go to the weldment toolbar. So in this, as we spoke earlier, we are using pipe type, like a circular cross section. So the cross section will be like 21 × 3 × 2.3, okay? So there you need to be selective, like if lines are in horizontal manner, so you should group it as, you should select them in a single group. So here this line, let's say this line, I am selecting in group one, okay? And the for the front line also, it is a horizontal line, so I am selecting it in one group. Now I will make a new group, so click on the new group. So this is a vertical, somewhat vertical line, not perfectly vertical, but angled. So I'm not able to select it, so right click for that. Yeah, and then you can do in that way. And again, new group. So separate lines, we will keep in a different group so that to avoid some issue with groove shaping. So as you can see here, we are having some issue with selection of pipe. So because there are two lines exactly overlapping. So what you can do, like you can right click and go to select other. Yeah, select other, so it will give some options. So the one, yes, this is the solid line which you want to select. And in that way, you can do the selection. Like once again, we will try select other. And then like that, you can see it is taking the selection. Again, a new group. So for a separate line, we will be making the new selection. So like that, you can select. And you can see here that the groove is not properly taking the shape of the profile. Okay, so this is how we will be making it. Okay, so here the groove is sitting perfectly. Let's check the front direction also. So here in upper ball joint area, we have like the pipes are sitting perfectly, the groove is okay. But this side, the right hand side, it is opened. Okay, so we can change this. Okay, so for that we need to again go to the feature. And there is a pink dot. So you click on that and the select the pipe which you want. So group three, yes. So group three, we can order it in three ways. So it is selected to the third order. If you change that, you can change the shape of the groove. So like that. So first is not okay. Second looks okay. It is taking the shape of the pipe correctly. So that can be taken as okay. So click on the tick mark and give the tick mark on the top right. Okay. So here also we will check if it is okay sitting, the groove is sitting properly or not. Okay. So in the front, let's check. Yeah. So in front, you can see it is not sitting properly. The line of the mount is short. Okay, so what we can do is, because it's a hard point and we cannot change it, so you either change the location of the clamp or you can increase this length. So as you know that we made previously 50 mm has been given there. Okay, so try to increase the length or try to adjust the offset. So let's say 55 and let's see if it is happening or not. Little bit it is still interfering, but I think we can make some adjustment in the length again and then it will sit properly. So this time we will give 58 or let's say give 60. It will be sufficient, more than sufficient this time. Okay, so now it is properly clearing. Okay, one thing to notice, you need to be very skilled in groove making because it's a very typical and complex groove. Okay, so yes, like this is the design of our AM which is ready. Okay. So yeah, this type of design is applicable for college level. If you are in a society, like, you know, you have a team in your college, you have BAJA, Supra and go-kart. Okay. You participate in that competitions and you build the car. Okay. So you can definitely use this technique. This is very easy to make. Okay. So with just using normal pipes, you can design a CAD, and with the pipes available from the market, you can easily make it. Okay. So similarly, you can make the design for lower control arm also. So start by making two horizontal lines along Z-axis for the rear lower control arm and front mount of the lower control arm. And after that, try to make the line which will pass to the knuckle axis. You can say caster axis if you see from the side view. And dimension them as per the setting or in such a way that there should be no clash. Okay, we need to leave some room for knuckle also. Okay, if you want to check how to make knuckle, you can refer my previous videos. I will drop the link of those in the description, in this video description. Okay, and then you can make the mount. There should be a mounting pipe for the shock absorber also. Okay, so here you can make. And yeah, just like this, like previously we performed, you can go to Weldment toolbars and you can make this pipe design. Okay. Yeah, so don't forget to make it in a group. Okay. Because if you will make entire design in a single group, it will give issue in the groove making. The groove will not be coming properly. So like that, even if it is not coming properly, what you can do, you can change the groove order like here. Okay. And if the groove is getting short or it is becoming very lengthy, you can always change the length. Okay. So like that, you can see our AM design. It's a basic design. Okay. It's not very much, like, just to give you guys idea how to easily make like a very economical idea. Okay. If you want high precision, you can go for CNC bending. So it will be more precise. Okay. You can also go for laser cutting grooves. So with help of laser cut grooves, your grooves will be coming in perfect shape. Surely you need to use some fixtures to do the welding of A-arms. Okay. So yeah, some minor adjustment in the groove I am doing here. And yeah, so that's how you can easily make. So I have just made the A-arms using straight arms, like straight lines. If you want them to be curved, you can use a curved profile as well. Alright, so yeah, thank you so much for your time, for watching this video. I will try my best to be as active as possible, and I hope to create more content like this. So thank you all. Goodbye.